Hi everybody, this is Andrew with the West Union Library again, and I'm just here going to bring you another virtual story time. And today we're going to read a book called How to Find an Elephant. As the title may suggest, it is all about how you can find an elephant. Now, as I do this, if you can see the pictures, make sure you keep your eyes out for elephants. Okay, so here we go. So it says How to Find an Elephant. The best time to look for an elephant is on an all-dull day when clouds hover over the horizon looking like spaceships and you're thinking up something to do. The best place to find an elephant is in the wild. You will need to pack some food and a pair of binoculars. You may want to take a flute and bring a blanket, one that's tasseled and brightly collared, with a story woven through the cloth to tell the elephant. The first thing you'll want to do is climb to the top of the nearest tree. Take out your binoculars and look for something large and gray. If you don't see an elephant, then you'll have to go into the jungle. Keep an eye out for elephant footprints. They look like this. But don't expect to hear elephants' footsteps because elephants walk on tiptoe. When you get thirsty, stop at a watering hole for a drink. While you are there, you can take a dip. And don't forget that elephants are fine swimmers. If you come to a house, knock on the door and politely say, "Has anyone seen an elephant?" And if no one has, then go deeper into the jungle. It may start to rain, but you can take shelter under a large leaf. While you wait out the storm, play a tune on your flute. You are bound to be hungry, so find a soft, shady spot and have your lunch, in case an elephant decides to join you. Gather some bamboo shoots and tree bark for the elephant to eat. You will need plenty, because elephants have big appetites. No pizza or chips, please. At some point, you will probably bump into a chimpanzee. If you are feeling brave, ask if you can swing on its vine. Be sure to jump off when you see an eagle's nest, and ask the eagle to carry you over the trees to the edge of the jungle. When you get there, take a good look around, and if you happen to spot something big and gray, tiptoe closer. You'll want to see if it's an elephant or not. If it's not an elephant, then you'll just have to keep looking. And if you begin to feel tired, go to the top of a hill that has long, lush grass swaying in the breeze and some crickets to sing you to sleep. Spread out your blanket and lie down. Remind yourself to have sweet dreams of elephants. If you should be wakened by the ground shaking and find yourself wrapped in a hug and lifted toward the sky, then you will know that an elephant has found you. And that's it. So I hope you guys enjoyed that story. Hopefully you seen an elephant. I'm sure you did. And now the song that we're going to do for the story time is Farmer in the Dell, because it's all about animals. You know, we read about elephants, so let's do a song about animals. I'm going to leave a link in the description of this video for that song, so you guys can watch it on YouTube and sing along. And for the craft, we are going to do paper plate elephants. And I'll also have a link in the description below so that you guys can see that. Basically, what you'll do is you'll take a paper plate or like just a piece of paper or like some construction paper, anything that you guys have, and you'll try to make it look as much like an elephant as you can. I'm sure that you guys will probably make some pretty awesome stuff. Don't be afraid to share it to our page on Facebook, the Adams County Library, and that'd be cool for us to see. And as always, I can speak for all the staff when we say that we're definitely ready to get back to work. We want to make sure it's as safe as possible for everybody. So that's kind of where we're at now, is just trying to see how that's going to work out And of course, we always want to give you guys the services you deserve, and you know, as far as everything you guys need. So you know, that's it for this virtual story time. Thank you, and stay safe and be healthy.